Welcome. Subscribe to AS Foundation, India's leading academy for CA course, and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Thank you.
Please come to question number 32 now. Ready? It says P Limited acquired 80% of the share capital of S Limited 2 years ago. Underline 2 years ago. In earlier question, it was acquired at the beginning, in the middle. But in this question, the shares were already acquired 2 years ago when the reserve of S Limited was 1,25,000 rupees. So that we will call pre-acquisition profit. So that will help me to find out goodwill. P Limited initial cash consideration was rupees. P Limited paid initial cash consideration of rupees 1 million. Additionally, P Limited issued 2 lakh share with a nominal value of rupee 1 and a current market value of 1.80. In this question, one extra working note you'll have to prepare. PC, purchase consideration. It was also agreed, add one more thing, that P Limited would pay a further rupees 5 lakh in 3 years time. Okay, so that is called deferred consideration. That also you will add at present value. Current interest rate is 10%. So you will take 5 lakh divided by 1.10 to the power 3. Divided by 1.10 to the power 3. In fact, they have given you the discounting factor also below. So instead of doing so much exercise, just multiply 5 lakh into present value factor of rupee 1.751. How much it comes to? 3,75,100 or 500. Okay, the shares and deferred consideration have not been recorded, underline, which means in the given balance sheet there is a problem. It is not a correct balance sheet. It is not a, because it does not include the shares issued and the promise to pay consideration. And how many years are over now? 2 years. So on the deferred consideration, we have to also add interest for 2 years, which means their profit figure is also wrong, because they should have passed one entry, interest account debit to deferred consideration. Interest would have gone to P&L account. That they have not done. So we have to do lot of rectification in this problem before we start consolidation. Is it right? So can you tell me what was total purchase consideration from the first paragraph? Try your luck. Total PC. What is the consideration paid for acquiring 80% share? Consideration in this question is of 3 items: cash, share, DC, deferred consideration. Time over. Anybody? Total consideration for goodwill calculation. So 17,35,500. Correct. 17,35,500. So that is my consideration paid. Cash paid 1 million. Shares issued 2 lakh into 1.80. And present value of deferred consideration 3,75,500. So if you add all of them, you will get 17,35,500. Okay. And out of these 3 items, one has been recorded in the books, cash paid. So that you will see on the asset side. Investment in S Limited at cost, that 1,000. Figures are in 1,000, so it is actually 1 million. But other 2 items you will have to record. Okay. balance sheet of P Limited and S Limited on 31/12/14. Non-current asset PPE, investment tick mark, this is wrong, 1000 is wrong figure. It should have been 17,35,500. Current asset, inventory, receivable, cash. Equity share capital tick mark, it is wrong because you have issued equity share. So it is understated figure. And then retained earning, and then retained earning also tick mark. You have not reduced the interest on deferred consideration for 2 years. That also you will have to adjust. Next line, one more item will come in balance sheet, securities premium. Do you agree? Because share of 1 rupee was issued at 1.80. So there is a securities premium angle also in this problem. That also will add. And then they have given non-current liability, current liability, further information, point number 1. At acquisition date, the fair value of S Limited plant exceeded the book value by rupees 2 lakh. So this 2 lakh tick mark, property, plant, equipment, first item, increase it by 2 lakh. But then you have to provide depreciation for how many years? Total life is 5 and 2 years are over. So 2 lakh divided by 5 into 2. How much? 2 lakh divided by 5 into 2. Is it 80,000? 80,000 depreciation they have not charged. Now you will deduct in post acquisition and deduct from PPE. So in PPE 2 adjustment plus 2 lakh minus 80,000. In analysis of profit, same 2 adjustment, pre-acquisition plus 2 lakh, post-acquisition minus 80,000. Wonderful, you have understood. Now I can give it as homework. Point number 2. There was a total silence after the word homework. For many years, S Limited had been selling some of its product under the brand name of M Limited. At the date of acquisition, the directors of P Limited value this brand at 2,50,000 with a remaining useful life of 10 years. The brand is not included in the balance sheet of S Limited. Same adjustment, understand. Pre-acquisition, you will add fair value of brand 2,50,000. Post-acquisition amortization, 2,50,000 divided by 10 years into 2 years completed. How much? 50,000. And in balance sheet, one new item will appear under intangible asset brand. Add 2,50,000 minus 50,000. Therefore, 2 lakh brand value will appear in the balance sheet. This adjustment we had done in one earlier question also. And then point number 3, goodwill has been impaired by rupees 2,80,000. So after calculating goodwill, reduce it by 2,80,000. And P Limited values the non-controlling interest using the fair value method, which means that goodwill impairment will be allocated between parent and NCI if you are using fair value method. At the date of acquisition, the fair value of 20% NCI was 3,80,000. Prepare the CBS on 31st December 2014. Very easy problem, but right here, most likely problem. What will you write? Most likely, highly probable. Okay. These are the questions that you can expect from the institute. Okay. Because it contains lot of adjustment and all fundamental adjustments they are asking you. So on the screen, you can see the consolidated balance sheet format. Same format we have been using. But this time a new item will appear in balance sheet, brand, under the head intangible asset. Start. I'll dictate. Trust me. Right. Consolidated balance sheet of P Limited as on 31/12/2014. As on 31/12/2014, serial number, particulars, rupees. And you write down rupees in thousand. What will you write? because the given balance sheet to you is rupees in 1000. So you have to convert all figures into rupees in 1000. Now in the exam also we'll follow this strategy. If the question gives you figures in 1000, you also prepare your answer in 1000. Lakh, lakh. Million, million. Okay? Preferably. Non-current asset. First write down capital A, assets. Under that one, non-current asset. Under non-current asset, small a, property, plant and equipment, PPE. One line blank. Point number B, intangible assets. Under that two items write, goodwill, brand. Keeping one line gap, goodwill, brand, one line blank. Point number two, current assets. Under current asset write, A, inventories, B, trade receivables, C, cash and cash equivalents, total. Over asset side, now write point number B, equity and liabilities. Under that write down, one, equity. Under equity, three items, share capital, other equity, non-controlling interest. Point number two, non-current liabilities. One line blank. Point three, current liabilities. Under current liabilities, you write one more line, others dash deferred consideration. Why in current liability? Because it is payable in the next year now. Out of 3 years, 2 years are over, correct? So now this amount is payable within 12 months from the reporting date. So deferred consideration will become current liability now, because out of 3 years, 2 years are over. One working note we have to prepare for finding the deferred consideration figure for balance sheet purpose. So this way one new adjustment has come, deferred consideration. Now we'll write down consolidated statement of changes in equity. Consolidated statement of changes in equity. Right hand side, five columns. Share capital, securities premium, retained earning, NCI, total. Five columns drawn, share capital, securities premium, retained earning, NCI, total. And then you write down below that particular column, point A, opening balance. Opening balance will be there. Point B, issue of shares. Issue of shares. This problem has one more line, issue of share. Point C, goodwill impairment. Goodwill impairment. Point C, goodwill impairment. One line blank. Point D, add share in post acquisition profit. Share in post acquisition profit. One line blank. Less finance cost on deferred consideration. Less finance cost on deferred consideration. Less finance cost on deferred consideration. One or two lines blank. Two lines blank, then total. This retained earning figure will be reduced because of the finance cost on deferred consideration. They have not provided interest on that. Now we'll provide. Okay. Now we will write working note 1. Cost of investment in S Limited. Cost of investment in S Limited. This working note will complete now only. Right hand side rupees. First write down point number A, cash paid. In bracket write down recorded in books. Cash paid recorded in books. Rupees in thousand. So if cash paid is rupees in thousand, amount will be 1000. Point number two write, B write. Shares issued. Right, not recorded in books. Not recorded in books. How many shares were issued? 2 lakh shares. Into issue price. And you are writing in rupees in thousand, so it comes to 360. Deferred consideration. Deferred consideration. How much is deferred consideration? 5 lakh into 0.751. You're writing in 1000. 375.5. Point number D. Total. What is the total? 1735.50. Is it right? Say yes. Now write down journal entry. Journal entry for rectification of investment. Journal entry for rectification of investment in S Limited. Do you think they have passed the correct entry? No. So you have recorded cash, but you have not recorded shares and deferred consideration. So only for that portion we have to further pass the entry. Write down, I will dictate investment in S Limited account debit. Investment in S Limited account debit. How much will you write? 360,000 plus 375,500. 735.50. Very good. To equity share capital. 200 into 1, 200. To securities premium. 200 into 0.80. 160. 200 into 0.80, 160. To deferred consideration. How much? 375.50. Do you agree? So because of this, whatever changes will take place in your answer, you have to give the effect. One more working note. Number 3. Balance in deferred consideration account. As on 31st December 2014. Balance in deferred consideration account as on 31-12-2014. Suppose you get a chance to answer that question. What will be the answer? one student is saying 4,54,000. 1355. Let me try. First, write opening balance. Opening balance. What is opening balance? 375.5 rupees in 1000. Add interest of first year at 10%. So that will be how much? 37. So what is the balance? A plus B, 400 something. 4313.05. Point number D, add interest of second year. Your balance will keep on increasing because interest will keep on getting added. You have computed present value. So after 3 years, your book value should also become equal to 5 lakh. So add the interest on this amount for 10%, 41.305. So point number E, balance on 31/12/2014, you add C plus D, 454.355. So what is the total finance cost we have to add? Total finance cost we have to consider in my calculation. So point number F, write down total finance cost. Total finance cost. How much you said? 78.855. Is it right now? Say yes. Now write down two more working notes. Working note 4, analysis of profit. Whose profit we are analyzing? S Limited. So working note 4, analysis of profit, S Limited. Working note 4, analysis of profit, S Limited. Keep 14 lines blank. Working note 5, calculation of goodwill. Format of goodwill, same format. Point A, consideration paid. Point B, add NCI at fair value. Add NCI at fair value. Point C, total A plus B. Point D, fair value of identifiable net asset. Under that, write 1, share capital. 2, pre-acquisition profit. One line blank. Point number E, goodwill. And in this problem, I will add 2 more lines. Point number F, less impairment. Less impairment. And point number G, goodwill on the date of consolidation. Goodwill on the date of consolidation. Is it right? So can we start now? Draw the format neatly, draw lines, etc., wherever required. Okay. because this is one of the most probable questions they should ask in the exam, such problems. So we'll start. We'll read the problem again. P Limited acquired 80% of share capital of S Limited 2 years ago when the reserve stood at ₹1,25,000. Come to analysis of profit, working note 4. Right? Retained earning. Right, retained earning. Rupees in 1,000 we are writing. So you just write 125. And if you look at the balance sheet, total is 300. Which means in the post acquisition column, you write 175. Correct? An adjustment we will do. This is their book value. 300 retained earning of subsidiary, we have apportioned pre and post 125 and 175. Understandable. Next line. P Limited paid initially cash consideration of rupees 1 million. P Limited issued 2 lakh shares. Face value rupee 1, issue price 180, and deferred consideration rupees 5 lakh. So come to working note 5. Consideration paid. Which number? 17 lakh. 1735.5. And from which working note you will get this number? 1. Working note 1. And I will also give the effect of journal entry in your statement of changes in equity. Your past one entry number 2 in your second working note, journal entry. Investment account debit to share capital to securities premium. So how much share capital you have issued? 200. In your consolidated statement of changes in equity, share capital, issue of share, right, 200. And how much was securities premium involved? 160, right, in securities premium, 160. And how much deferred consideration we will write in balance sheet? Deferred consideration in balance sheet, working note 3 figure. This figure, working note 3 figure. 454.355. So go to balance sheet liability side. Deferred consideration 454.355. And that finance cost which we have calculated in working note 3. How much was finance cost? 78.855. This we will reduce from retained earning in SOCIE on the screen. Finance cost on deferred consideration. What was this working note number? 3. And you have not reduced earlier, now reduce. Tell me the amount. 78.855. In bracket, write down. So this completes my adjustment of that first paragraph. Okay. Understood? Then it says balance sheet now. PPE. PPE. Come to balance sheet. Asset side. Write down first whatever is given. 5500 plus 1500. Now there is an adjustment also. Adjustment number 1. The fair value of the plant exceeded the book value by rupees 2 lakh. Plant has a remaining useful life of 5 years from this date. So come to balance sheet asset side, property, plant, equipment plus 200. and minus depreciation 80. This is depreciation. This is increase in fair value. So what is my final figure now? 7120. Check 7120. And the second effect of this will go to analysis of profit. Keep the first one or two lines blank, already done. Now write down increase in fair value of, under that write down A, plant 200. Keep two lines blank and write down less additional depreciation on plant. Additional depreciation on plant 200 divided by 5 years into 2 years. Negative amount 80 in post column. Okay. So if you give second effect properly, the answer is it will, your balance sheet will tally. Now we'll come to next line. Investment already done. Yes or no? And then is inventory. Inventory, receivable, cash. Good news. No adjustment. Take total, right? How much is total of inventory? 650. Total of receivable. Total of cash. Total of the three items. 300. 1500. Come to liability side. Come to SOCIE. Share capital opening balance. Write 2000 here. First line. Opening balance of securities premium is nil. Opening balance of retained earning is 1400. Then come to working note number 5 on goodwill. Wait a minute. Computer G is hanging. Working note 5. Goodwill. There you've written share capital. Right there. $500. And what about that retained earning? $300. Already written? 170, 125 and 175. Okay. Then you come to balance sheet. I'll dictate. In balance sheet, write non-current liability. 3400. 3000 plus 400, 3400. And then in balance sheet, you also write current liability. 1250 plus 650. How much? 1900. Is it right? 1900. Balance sheet items are over. Say yes. Will you listen to me and write properly? So I'll speak very slowly. Listen to me and write carefully. You'll be able to understand. Adjustment number 1 we have done. Totally we have done that fixed asset revaluation and its depreciation. Now listen to me carefully. Adjustment number 2. For many years, S Limited had been selling some of its product under the brand name M Limited. At the date of acquisition, directors of P valued this brand at ₹2,50,000 with a remaining life of 10 years, the brand is not included in S Limited balance sheet. Come to balance sheet first. All of you, come to balance sheet first. Balance sheet, asset side. Intangible asset. Under that brand, write down 250 minus 250 minus 50. 200. 250 minus 50, 200. And then you come to analysis of profit, working note number 4. Working note number 4. And right there in pre column, you have already written increase in fair value of plant. Below that, write brand. Below that, write brand. In pre column, write 250. Next line, write down. Next line, amortization of brand. Less amortization of brand. Less amortization of brand, you write down 50. Is it right? Amortization of brand, you have written 50. Correct? Huh. In bracket. Next point is the consolidated goodwill has been impaired by Rs. 2,80,000. Go to the working note on goodwill. Go to the working note on goodwill. In working note on goodwill, last second item, less goodwill impairment, you have written. Write 280 in bracket. 280 in bracket, written. Second effect, go to statement of changes in equity. Statement of changes in equity. You have written one line there, goodwill impairment. Am I right? But because you are going to measure fair value of NCI, you will apportion it between parent and NCI. Come to retained earning column. Right there in retained earning column against goodwill impairment, 80% of 280. How much is that? 224. Sure. And in that NCI column, write 20%. 20% is how much? 56. Write 56. 56. Okay, 20% written, 56. Say yes, yes. In bracket, both figures in bracket. Next line is P Limited Group values its non-controlling interest. P Limited Group values its non-controlling interest at fair value. At the date of acquisition, the fair value was 380. So first you go to goodwill working note. First you go to goodwill working note, and there you write down add NCI. How much? 380. 380 positive. Go to statement of changes in equity. In statement of changes in equity, you write down 380. Written? Where you have written? You can write in opening balance, no problem. Next line, But there is no next line over. All adjustments you have done. So what will you do, dear student? You will go to analysis of profit. Take the total. Any volunteer who wants to answer total? 575. And post column 45. And then you write here two names, P Limited and NCI. P Limited share is 80%, NCI share is 20%. This 575 you will transfer to this pre-acquisition, okay, here 575. And this 45 you will divide in the ratio of 80-20. How much? 30, 36 and 9, write down 36 and 9. Wait a minute. Now I will complete this goodwill part. You have to help me. How much was consideration paid? 1735.50. Add NCI 380. Total 2115.50. Share capital 500. Pre-acquisition profit 575. Total of share capital and pre-acquisition profit 1075. Therefore, goodwill 1040.5 less impairment 280. Therefore, balance of goodwill on date of consolidation 760.5. Dear student, go to balance sheet. In balance sheet, write goodwill asset side. Balance sheet asset side goodwill 760.50. Now you come to statement of changes in equity. Statement of changes in equity. Have you written there add post acquisition profit? In retained earning column, write 36. In retained earning column, write 36. In NCI column, write 9. NCI column 9. Now first what you do, complete each line in statement of changes in equity. So tell me, what is the total of opening balance in total column? 3780. Total of issue of share line, last column, 360. Total of goodwill impairment in the last column, 280. Total of finance cost on deferred consideration in last column, 78.855. Total of post acquisition profit in last column, 45. Correct. Now tell me vertical total. First you tell me total of share capital 2200. Share capital total is 2200. Agreed. Securities premium column total 160. Retained earning total 1133.145. Right? Once again, retained earning total 1133.145. NCI total 333. And total of the total column 3826.145 is right. 3826.145. Then now please come to liability side. Share capital first column 2200. Share capital, first column 2200. Other equity, take total of securities premium plus retained earning. Total of securities premium plus retained earning is how much? 1293.145. Total of share capital and other equity in the outer column. 3493.145. Now write NCI in the outer column. 333. NCI in the outer column is 333. Do you agree? So what is the balance sheet total? 9580.50. Asset side. Same. Amazing. 9580.50. Do you agree? Yes or no? Louder, yes. Yes. So balance sheet total, once again, last time 9580.50. Okay. NCI total was 333. Share capital total is 2200. Other equity total is how much? 1293.145. Correct. Now any query? No query. Why? Understood. Cash impact of deferred consideration. We have not paid. It will be paid at the end of third year. Deferred consideration will be paid at the end of third year. So it is only a liability, and the liability is increasing every year at the rate of 10%. So no cash has been paid till date on deferred consideration liability. So that will just keep on appearing in the balance sheet every year. Okay, any other question? No question. Okay. So now you come to next question number 33. Read question number 33. Again, a very good question. Question number 33, I will read. Pay attention. Balance sheet of P Limited and S Limited on 30th June. Underline the date 30th June 2018. What is the balance sheet date? 30th June 2018 are given below. Non-current asset, land, plant and equipment, investment. Current asset, inventory, receivable, bank, then share capital, 50 paise. What is 50 paise? 50p means 50 paise means face value is 50 paise. So can you guess the number of shares of S Limited? It must be 2000. Retained earning, non-current liabilities, 8% loan stock, current liabilities. P Limited acquired 75% of S Limited on 1st July 2015. Underline 75%. On which date? 1st July 15. And what is the balance sheet date given to you? 30th June 18. How many years are over? 3 years are over. Previous problem, 2 years were over. Now in this question, 3 years are over. So keep that in mind, because that might be required for some depreciation, amortization calculation, interest calculation, etc. So what was the balance in retained earning of S Limited on that day? 1150. That is your pre-acquisition. Now on the balance sheet, what is the retained earning of subsidiary? 3150. So can I say 2000 is the post-acquisition change? Yes. Next line, P Limited paid rupees 3500 for its investment in the share capital of S. At the same time, P Limited invested in 60% of S, 8% loan stock. What is the meaning of this line? P Limited invested in 60% of stock, loan stock of S Limited, means they have also invested in the loan. Let us look at the balance sheet, liability side. 8% loan stock of subsidiary is 500. Last second line, second column. Out of 500, 300 is held by P Limited, correct? So what is the total cost of investment in share? 3500. How much is the investment in loan asset? 300. So if I look at the total amount of investment made in share plus loan, 3500 plus 300 is 3800. Go to balance sheet asset side, third line. Investment. How much is that? 8000, but it is not telling. So out of 8000, 3500 is investment in share of S, 300 is investment in the loan stock of S. What about the remaining investment? Huh? Yes, it is not mentioned that it is in S Limited, so they are other investment. They are an other investment will appear in balance sheet. Other investment will appear in. So in this question, we have to just understand all investments are not S Limited. Investment in S is 3500 plus 300. So what is the balancing figure? 4200. That will appear in balance sheet. There is a small typing error. S Limited investment is written 4250. Make it 0. Because the total is 4250. Not the investment. Is it right? So investment of S Limited column, you make it 0. Okay. Now I'll read the adjustment number 2. Ready for adjustment number 2. Listen to me. At the reporting date, P recorded a payable of S, payable to S, 400. This did not agree to the corresponding amount in S financial statement of rupees 500. The difference is cash in transit. Now see the effect. Tick mark, receivable. Reduce receivable by 500, minus 500. Reduce current liability by 400. Increase cash and cash equivalent by 100. So tick mark receivable, tick mark bank, tick mark current liabilities. Understood? We have done it 4 or 5 times before. No explanation required here. Point number 3. At the date of acquisition, it was determined that S land carried at cost had a fair value of. Now the fair value is not printed there. Had a fair value of write down 3750. Had a fair value of 3750. Have you written? I will repeat. At the date of acquisition, it was determined that S Limited's land carried at cost of 2500 had a fair value of 3750. Fair value of S plant was determined to have a fair value of in excess of its carrying amount. Again, here the amount is not mentioned. So fair value in excess of carrying amount buy ₹500 write down. Fair value in excess of its carrying amount, buy ₹500. And had a remaining life of 5 years. These values have not been recorded by S Limited. Understand. In case of land, depreciation issue is not there. Increase the value of the land by 1250. Why 1250? 3750 minus 2500. One effect, land in balance sheet increase by 1250. Second effect, pre-acquisition profit will increase by 1250. Now let us talk about plant. Increase plant by 500. Increase pre-acquisition profit by 500. Second, depreciation on 500 for 3 years. 500 divided by 5 into 3. 300. Reduce 300 from plant in balance sheet. Reduce 300 from post-acquisition profit. Understood? So many times we have done now. You must have got bored, but I don't mind. Point number 4. The PE Limited Group uses fair value method to value the NCI. So again, fair value method. For this purpose, the subsidy share price on the date of acquisition should be used. The subsidy share price on acquisition date was 0.20 rupees per share. Now you have to find out how many shares are held by NCI. You said total number of shares are 2000 into 25%, 500 into 0.20, 100. There is a small typing error, sorry. The share price on the date of acquisition was 2.20. Now multiply 500 into 2.20. So three correction we have to do in this problem. The fair value of the land on the date of acquisition is 3750. Increase in the value of plant is 500. And the share price of subsidiary is 2.20. So write 2.20. 500 into 2.20. One effect in NCI, in SOCIE, opening balance. This time we'll write in opening balance because we are in the third year. Okay. And second effect in goodwill working note, second line, fair value of NCI on acquisition date 1100. Goodwill was impaired by 100 rupees. Oh. Reduce from goodwill 100 and reduce in SOCIE from retained earning and from NCI in the ratio of 75:25, which is 75 and 25. Understood all the adjustment. Now we'll first draw format. Draw this format. Balance sheet format. Complete the format first. CBS of P Limited. The date should be as on 30th June 2018. CBS of P Limited as on, take the date from question book, 30th June 2018. Serial number, particulars, rupees. Serial number A, assets. 1. Non-current asset. Under that, 1 or A, PPE. PPE. Under that, 2 points, A, land, B, plant and equipment. And then you write down point number 2, intangible assets. Under intangible asset, next line, write goodwill. In this question, one more line will come in non-current asset, investment. That entire investment is not in subsidiary. Some investment is other investment, into bracket write others, okay? And then write down point number two, current assets. In current asset write small a, inventories. One line blank, small b, trade receivables. One line blank, small c, cash and cash equivalent. Then one line blank, total. Is it right? This is asset side. Below that now write down point number b, equity and liabilities. Under equity and liabilities, one equity. Under that, three items. A, share capital. B, other equity. One line blank, C, NCI. One line blank, point number two, little fast, non-current liabilities. Under non-current liability, write financial liabilities. Next line, loan stock, 8% loan stock. 8% loan stock. One line blank, point three, current liabilities. Point three, current liabilities. Next line, total. Total. Those who have done, now write down. Next format. Consolidated statement of changes in equity. Consolidated statement of changes in equity. Right hand side, four columns, share capital, retained earning, NCI, total. Under that, three lines. First A, opening balance. B, post acquisition profit. One line blank, C, less goodwill impairment. Less goodwill impairment. Less goodwill impairment. One or two more lines blank. And then write down total. This is your statement of changes in equity. Right. And then you write down next working note one. Analysis of profit. Analysis of profit. Two columns. Pre-acquisition, post-acquisition. Keep 14 lines blank. Then write down working note 2, calculation of goodwill. Calculation of goodwill. Under that, consideration paid. Point number A, consideration paid. Point B, add NCI at fair value. Add NCI at fair value on date of acquisition. Add NCI at fair value on date of acquisition. One line blank. Point C, total. A plus B. Point D, fair value of identifiable net assets. Fair value of identifiable net assets. Fair value of identifiable net asset, 1, share capital. 2, pre-acquisition profit. In bracket, working note 1. in bracket working note 1, one line blank, point E goodwill, point E goodwill, and point F less impairment, and then point G goodwill on date of consolidation, goodwill on the date of consolidation. This is our format. Now we'll continue tomorrow.